Okay, Minister? Minister. Minister. Hello, it's wonderful to meet you. I'm the crazy Irish woman.
Why are you crazy?
Well, I think the audience would agree that I run around like a headless chicken in very unusual colours.
It's wonderful.
We like this, Minister. Before we say anything to Minister, first of all, can I just acknowledge you are the first Minister for Social Affairs and Health to join us in the Zero Conference in 10 years. Thank you for that. Yeah. Yeah, seriously, we haven't had that, and that means a lot to us. But also, there's a few things I've been given little tips on you. One is that you did social work, as that was the root to your career, and this is something that you genuinely care about and are committed to. The other thing that I heard is that you come from the better side of Austria, is that the western side, the Alps. Somebody said he comes from the better side. I'm not sure what that is. But with that, Minister, please, we are so delighted to have you. Thank you so much for your time. And please take the stage.
Western part of Austria, Vorarlberg. It's a beautiful place, but all the other places in Austria are also very beautiful, especially Vienna is beautiful, okay? And now, ladies and gentlemen, my short speech to you is a challenge because I have such yellow marks on my speech. Yellow mark says slight change. So now I try. Yes, it works. Okay, so thank you for the invitation, ladies and gentlemen. I would like to thank you very much for the opportunity to speak to you today in times of, let me say, multiple crises. It is more important than ever to make social justice the focus of political decisions. I called for this just 2 weeks ago at the UN Social Commission in New York. All people must have the same opportunities to participate in society regardless of their social or health circumstances. For me, this includes in particular the fight for the full inclusion of people with disabilities. This is exactly what the Zero Project stands for. And let me say, Mr. Essler, congratulations to Zero Project. It's such a great event. Meanwhile, all over the world, we can be proud in Austria of your work you've done in the last years. Congratulations, Mr. Essler. Initiative to provide people with disabilities worldwide access to education, employment, and social participation is both inspiring and motivating. By exchanging best practices and creating a global network, the Zero Project not only promotes dialogue, but also provides a platform for Austria to learn from the experiences of other countries while sharing its own innovative approaches. The topics of today's event are the forefront of Austria's National Action Plan on Disability. Therefore, allow me to give you a few details on our strategy before addressing inclusive education and the inclusion of people with disabilities into the labor market. The National Action Plan after National Action Plan aims to further implement the UN Convention on the Rights of Persons with Disabilities in Austria. I'm pleased that in the sense of disability mainstreaming, it covers almost all areas of life in 8 chapters and 55 subchapters. In line with the current core topics of Zero Project, there is, of course, also a chapter on education and one on employment. The expertise of civil society, especially representatives of people with disabilities, was essential in the drafting process. My ministry, which is responsible for coordinating the National Action Plan and for the national coordination of the UN Convention, has always paid attention to the participation of people with disabilities and continues to do so in the implementation phase. The contents of the National Action Plan have become even more important as they offer implementation opportunities for the recommendations issued by the UN Committee on the Rights of Persons with Disabilities after the state review of Austria in August last year. These recommendations must be a top priority for disability policy in the upcoming months and years. I see the role of my ministry not only as a coordinating, but also as a connecting focal point. We can only implement the convention successfully if all federal ministries and regions, as well as the civil society, participate in this process. Inclusive education and employment of people with disabilities are essential cornerstones and serve as crucial keys to creating an inclusive society. Inclusive education is a fundamental human right that ensures every individual access to high quality education, regardless of their abilities. Digitalization plays an important role in breaking barriers, facilitating access to information and learning resources. It also enables participation in the educational process and unfolds individual capabilities. As Minister of Social Affairs in Austria, the inclusion of people with disabilities into employment is particularly important to me. Not only does it enable people with disabilities to lead independent lives, but also to enjoy social recognition. This year, my ministry will invest over 380 million euros in this sector. In order to make the entry to labor market as smooth as possible, it is especially important to provide young people with disabilities with appropriate training and support. This is why NEBAR, our Netzwerk Berufliche Assistenz, was developed. With its Occupational Assistance Network Service, it is an umbrella brand for a need-based support system for people with disabilities, particularly for young people who are marginalized or at risk of marginalization. The services offered by NEBAR are key instruments in the Austrian labor market policy for people with disabilities. Measures such as youth coaching, Ausbildungsfit, vocational training assistance and job coaching programs ensure a continuous support system. These measures constitute the core components of the subsidy landscape provided by the Federal Ministry of Social Affairs. To facilitate a successful entry into the labor market for young people, there is youth coaching that assists them in services. I would like to draw particular attention to the visibility of women, girls with disabilities. They are often subject to multiple forms of discrimination, making it even more important to enable women with disabilities to equally participate in all areas of life. Despite the progress made, there are still challenges in the field of inclusion, education, and employment of people with disabilities. Therefore, it is important for governments, business, and society to work together to create an inclusive environment where everyone can unleash their full potential. Only if we focus on people's potential and opportunities rather than their disabilities, we can ensure a future where inclusion is not just a word, but a reality lived by all. Finally, once more, I would thank to Mr. Martin Essel, his foundation, and the entire Zero Project team for the impressive organization of this conference. I hope we all leave this conference with inspiring ideas and take the next steps toward a world without barriers. Thanks a lot.
Thank you so much, Minister. Will you join us again next year, do you think? Can we bring you back?
Maybe.
Maybe? We'd love you to.
Maybe when I'm minister once more.
But we will be minister once more. I think that's a little bit of a hint. Thank you so much, Minister. It was wonderful to have you. Now, ladies and gentlemen, before you please move from your seats, we have one last small intervention before I'm going to quickly just run through what's happening later on this evening. I call this man Yoda. And I call him Yoda because he is the big, kind-hearted man who has been the backbone of so many initiatives around inclusion for people with disabilities. For many of us as a mentor, he gives his time endlessly. He travels around the world. And what we would love to do is hear a little bit about his initiative that he's leading on aging. And I would love to invite to the stage Mr. Luis Gallegos. Where are you, my friend Yoda? Where are you? Please tell me you're here. Or am I going to have to do some dancing? Am I going to have to do some dancing? Has anybody seen Yoda out there? Luis Gallegos, Caroline Casey, has you on her list? Okay. Right, well, while we're waiting for Luis Gallegos, I'm just going to quickly run through what's happening this evening. So you know it's the award ceremony. 6 o'clock sharp it starts. We will be giving out the awards for the best practices and innovations and policies. It will run very tightly and smoothly. We have this down to a fine art, myself and Wilfred. Wilfred will be wearing a very lovely suit. I am going to be dressed out in one of our friends who's given me an outfit, as I would say in Ireland, a guna. I'll be coming in a green guna and silver sparkly boots. I want you to bring all the energy that you have. We have 3 small keynotes as part of our award ceremony. We will start with the usual Le Crunch singing, and then after the awards, we will be having dinner. It's actually a really, really good night. It's enjoyable for everybody. And we love to say, though there are the people in the room this year who have been recognised, it's part now of an enormous group of innovations, practices and policy that have been recognised by the Zero Project. So, if Mr. Gallegos is not going to join me in the room, I can actually say to you all, and please bring on that music because I think I'm standing here on my own, I will see you back here at 6 o'clock this evening in my sparkly green dress with my green jacket, and make sure that you've got your clapping hands in order. And once again, thank you for being so patient with me and for all the energy you bring. So let's bring on the crunch and close this off until 6 o'clock this evening. Let me hear the music, please. The music, because I can't sing. That's it. Okay, go give me some volume. Okay, everybody, out you go. See you at 6. Woo, come on now. You got it now. I'll see you in my new outfit. Join me in the dance scene. That's where you need to be.